Yeah. We just rolled in the basement. It's one of those Kramer classics. You see that? So, there I was at my local guitar center, just minding my own business, picking up something, metronome maybe, and for my daughter. And used for a couple of hundred bucks. And I was like, wow. Is that Satchel? Guy's like, yeah, it's been signed by Steel Panther. And that's when I knew it was Destiny. You got your Satchel, you got what's left of the Michael Starr, somewhat worn off, Lexi Fox, and of course, Stick Zedinya, probably the greatest rock star name of all time. And, you know, the signatures might have even hurt its value a little bit because not everyone knows or is into Steel Panther, though they should be. And, yeah, man. So I gave myself a little Christmas present. It was cheap. You know, if it was really any more money, I probably would have skipped it, but it was so cheap. I love the oil finish neck, and believe it or not, just weirdness, my buddy Bobby had come over with all those San Dimas guitars, and he had one of these Kramers. And he brought it over, and I was checking it out, and I was like, geez, I really dig it. So, you know, when I spotted the other Kramer, he let me borrow it to see if I liked it, and I did. So I was like, okay, maybe I'll pick it up. So the rest is history. You know, it's not as nice. This is the Floyd Rose 2. The original had the Floyd Rose, but you know, for the money, it's just an incredibly nice playing guitar. So, you know, I thought I'd come on here, do a quick video. One weird thing is this is like a volume tone. I almost think it should be volume tone, but that way you can control the volume of both pickups with one volume knob, but... Right, it's like I think it's extreme, right? Anyway, that's it. I'm playing TH2 by Overloud, and I'm running the George Lynchbox head with the Ultra XL head, and no effects other than the head, a cab, and a reverb. Got a really great distortion on the head. You know, very responsive. Much better the second time around. Mm-hmm. work on that one. It's a little pentatonic workout for you. It's easy. So is it 1-2-4 or 1-3-4? 1-3-4. Do the one in the stretch. Anyway, here's a little finger bender for you. All right, guys. I really don't know any Christmas songs. Maybe. See, I told you I didn't know any Christmas songs. Merry Christmas. Happy New Year. Maybe I'll see you before the start of the new year, because my buddy Bobby's been asking me to do a little lesson on Bark at the Moon. And there's actually, I've seen out there four different ways to play the intro. And I play it like... ending with the G. But there's a whole bunch of other versions out there, but I think that's the most accurate one. But that's a video for another time. All right, guys. Have a great night. See ya.